I'll say it once, I'll say it again. Simple paint schemes are sometimes the best paint schemes. Here's Brad Keselowski's 2020 Discount Tire Ford Mustang. Howdy, howdy, folks. It's Diecast Buffet here again, back with another NASCAR Diecast review. Today's car is going to be Brad Keselowski's 2020 Discount Tire Ford Mustang. And it's crazy to think that this cat's been sponsored by Discount Tire for a decade, man. A freaking decade, man. That is insane. And this is the 2020 running of the car. And how fitting that this paint scheme was literally released days before he went to Victory Lane at Bristol Motor Speedway. That was an insane finish. I mean, it was one of the best Bristol races I have ever watched in my life. Like, literally, 2019 was one of the worst Bristol races ever. I mean, it was so bad, right? And even though Keselowski won, I'm not even a fan of Keselowski, but guess what, guys? Guess what? I love his diecasts, and it was an amazing race. Even though my guy, Chase Elliott, lost, it was an amazing race, man. And that's how you know it was a good race. When your driver wrecks out, a driver you don't really, you know, cheer for wins, that's a darn good NASCAR race. Hey, it felt like 2002, I'll be honest with you. It had so many cautions. The racing was fantastic, multi-groove. It was just... God, man, they need to take that, bottle it up, and bring it to every short track. It was perfect. Anyways, so here we go. We got Brad Keselowski's 2020 Discount Tire Ford Mustang. Very cool paint scheme design. You know, I mean, to some people, they might be like, oh, they should change it up. But I mean, it's iconic paint scheme. You know, it's been with them even back to the Nationwide days. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get it right out of the box. Alrighty, folks. Here we are again reviewing a Discount Tire Ford Mustang. And first off, you can see the skirt down here definitely needs a little bit of some touch-up with the paint. But, I mean, the paint scheme for this car, I tell you what, it's not the Penske Scallops. It's not, you know, the Ryan Blaney Menards. But it is a iconic paint scheme. And it has been around for 10 years now. I mean... You know what? I like it. I really do. I like it. They've literally ran this paint scheme year after year after year, but it's really a paint scheme I actually have grown to enjoy. Sometimes it might not be the most eye-catching, you know, they do release it every year, but this is in a lot of ways, a throwback to Keselowski's, you know, early days in, you know, NASCAR, back when he was driving the 22 car for Penske in the Nationwide Series, which he did win a championship. He won a Nationwide championship, and of course in 2012 he won the Sprint Cup. So he's one of a handful of drivers to win both of them, the Nationwide / Xfinity, and of course a Cup championship. And then over here to the roof of this diecast, you got tires.com, Discount Tire, Penske, Ford. And you go over here to the nose of this thing. I tell you what, man, this is a very cool paint scheme. But, you know, it's so simple. You know, to the average fan, it's probably not the most eye-catching diecast, but I tell you what, though, as someone who just sometimes likes good paint schemes, you know, it's just a good paint scheme. It's a good paint scheme to have. You got the Mustang logo there. I think the Mustang logo could be a little bit bigger there. Also, shout out to blue paint on my hands. That's cool. You got it's dry. Don't worry. You got Lincoln welders. You got Sunoco. You got a small little pinstripe that, you know, wraps around the bottom here. And of course, you got the number two there. That is all good and dandy, but I mean, honestly, besides this little headlight right here, man, the nose is very well wrapped. Good job, Lionel, besides a little Ford logo, too. Very good job, Lionel. And then over here to the left side of this diecast. Now, while I don't have the Cup Series banner and all that jazz, this was made before then. You got the NASCAR race car, NASCAR Cup Series. You got the blue Goodyear, which I don't know why, but it looks good. Pun intended, you got Ford, you got Pertec, whatever that is, PPG. Speaking of which, PPG does not sponsor Ryan Blaney anymore. You know, I find that hard to believe, but they sponsor Brad Keselowski now. I mean, it's crazy. You know, they switched their crew chiefs around. I guess they switched their sponsors, too. You got Mazak, and you got Dent Wizard, and what is that? Safety Clean. You got Auto Trader over here. Discount Tire. I like the font. I just like that. It's kind of goofy. I like that. I got Wabash, Alliance Truck Parts, and Snap-on on the right rear corner. And then over here to the caboose of this diecast. And good lord, what in the world happened over here to the right rear? I mean, good god, look at the paint splats here. I mean, wow. That is messed up. That's definitely some raced wear damage. You know what? If you really wanted to, maybe little Wrangler 3 will do this, but you could make a Bristol raced win out of this car, right? You could do it. I mean, you could. You could make a Bristol race win. I think it'd be really cool. I don't think they're going to make it in authentics, but if for some chance they needed to make a Brad Keselowski diecast, they might do what they did with Kansas and say, okay, we got to pick one Keselowski car. Let's go with Bristol. So you got discount tire. Let's get you taken care of. Imagine that. I got the red spoiler. And one thing I want to say real quick is the wheels. Wheels are very, very nice looking on this one. Very sharp. I mean, this one's a little bit hazy, but they're pretty good. I like that. Very clean. This is what I was talking about with the inconsistency with the Jack Lynx Ryan Blaney and the Shell Penzel Joey Logano. Both of those had really bad wheel issues, but the Keselowski discount tire, very nice indeed. And then over here to the right side of this discount tire Ford Mustang, I mean, just look at that, the number 2, that beautiful, one of the most iconic numbers in motorsports, the Penske 2. And I tell you what, all the drivers have driven that car, man. Keselowski's driven, guess what? Keselowski has driven the number 2 car for, what now, what, 10 years, 10 years. This cat has been driving this car, the 2 car, for 10 years now. That is just insane. God, I remember him driving the 2 car his first couple races, you know, it's like a TNT, you know, Pocono and all that jazz, you know, way back in yesteryear. Wow. And then over here to the roof of this car, and you know, I say this with every Penske diecast I review, but I really do appreciate when they do this. They take the number, they put it directly in the middle like it should be, and they don't have nothing on the roof flaps. Like, I just wish Hendrick would do this. I wish Ganassi would do this. I wish all the big teams would do this. And I think it looks good. I think it looks very good when the number is centered in the middle. There's no BS over here. Looks good. And of course, you got your Keselowski joint over there. Man, I freaking want some coffee. I need a swig of coffee. But so you got Keselowski here. You got the Werf logo on the deck lid. Man, I still think about that 2020 Werf car. And man, I really wish they produced that. But of course, we got the 2019. Maybe they'll make it for 2021. Who freaking knows? Holy cow, folks. I mean, this is a fantastic, solid diecast. Like, if you just want a solid diecast for your collection, I'd say the quality on this one is really good. I mean, look at the wheels. The wheels are not really all over the place. They're quite consistent. I mean, sure, this one's a little bit lighter. It's like maybe they started running out of paint or something. But, I mean, they're sharp. You could see the line around them. It looks like a freaking wheel, you know. Some of these colored wheels, man, I tell you, they really mess them up. Like, they're splotched. Like, this one would be smaller and this one would be bigger. It's just, it's very inconsistent, right? But with this diecast, and this was like this last year, too, for the 2019 version, it was very consistent. Why? I have no freaking clue, but they did it again with the 2020. Sure, it doesn't have the Cup Series banner, but guess what? All I gotta do, pop some rivets off, swap it out, swap it in, you're good to go. And you can make this, you could put the Cup Series banner, you could put, you could freaking take the back windshield, and you could take the, what is this right here? You could take the freaking Busher one and replace it if you want to. But anyways, let me know what y'all think about this diecast down below in the comment section. I think it's a very solid diecast. Look, it's not ever going to touch the Werf paint scheme. I'm sorry, that's one of the most beautiful paint schemes to ever wrap a Ford, a Chevy, a Toyota, whatever it is, a freaking Pontiac Grand Prix. It could be a Ford Mercury. I don't care. That Werf car is one of the best paint schemes of all time. This one might be nowhere near that, but it's a solid diecast. Absolutely recommend it. Thank y'all so much for watching the video. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Helps out the channel tremendously. Yeah, me and my terrible singing. Hope y'all enjoy the video. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And of course, go ahead and check me out on Instagram at DiecastBuffet. You know, if you really like custom NASCAR diecasts, and you like to see paint schemes like this, and you like to see, you know, diecasts being made like this, go ahead and check me out on Instagram at DiecastBuffet. I post a lot of cool stuff like that. With all that being said, hope you're having a great one. DiecastBuffet, signing off.